Hey guys, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, we'll be looking at three new things that are added to Laravel version 8.79.0. And there is also one good news that Laravel version 9 beta is already out. And if you want to test it out, you can just install it in your laptop and try. But in this video, we'll be looking at what are the things that are added to this version 8.79.0. And in the next video, we'll be looking at this beta version. So the first thing that has been added is this onLastPage on the Paginator instance. So if you look here in the PR, so before there was this onFirstPage and this has more pages method, but there was not this onLastPage. Suppose let's say we wanted to check if we were on the last page before, then we had to do it like this. If the Paginator doesn't have any more pages, and this Paginator variable is whatever we get whenever we run Paginate method on the Eloquent. So now we can easily do this if the Paginator is on the last page, and we can perform whatever action that we want to. The second thing that has been added is this full text search for MySQL and PostgreSQL. So there are now two methods, which are this where full text and or where full text. These are the two methods we can use if we want the full text search. So here in the first parameter, we can pass the column's name that we want to search, and the second parameter is whatever the value that we want to search here inside this columns, and third parameter is this array where we can pass mode and this expanded as true. And if you want this full text functionality, then there is one this method in the migration as well, this full text search. Here we want the full text search functionality on the title and body, so we can pass it like this over here. By using this full text functionality, we can easily search the content on the string based columns. And third and the final thing that has been added is this whenContains and whenContainsAll to the Stringable class. Before there was this contains and containsAll method, but now whenContains and whenContainsAll method is also added. So it is just a convenient method. So before, we had to do something like this. We had to write here if condition, and if the condition matches, then we can just write here like this. Basically, the chain of this string method, we had to break it. But now there is this whenContains method, so now we can just accomplish it without breaking the chain.